let's tackle that issue of drainage. Some estimates show it would take as much as $60-70 million to fix all of Stark County's drainage problems. What's the best approach to this problem? How would you make it?
Well, in a perfect world, would we have a drainage district or something like that? Sure. When Muskingum Watershed decided to reduce their assessment that they put on to solve the drainage problems, which we are part of the Muskingum Watershed, I asked him, could we leave the assessment on and give those monies back to the individual counties to start work on their drainage projects? We have committed, $500,000 my first year there, $500,000 the second year. In the last 3 years, we've committed over $2.7 million. But what we do is we partner. We partner with the Muskingum Watershed. We partner with the USGS. We're doing the Fulton Relief Bid. If anybody's been up there by St. Michael's, the Fulton Relief Bid, which is a perfect partnership of county, Ohio Public Works, Jackson Township, and Plain Township. So we're knocking them off. And that Gary Downer is the ditch guru, I'd like to say, for the county engineer's office. And that's the other thing. We took the politics out of the ditching program. It used to be you call in to the commissioner's office, and if you had a complaint, commissioners would come out, and the county engineer would either come out and do it or not do it. Now we prioritize them. We hire local contractors. That's a way of putting money back into our community. And one of the things this year, because we had a great year of clean ditches, we put an additional $1.5 million into the ditch fund. We've got four good contractors, Winger, Haymaker, Bechtel, and Jeffries, that are doing good work for us, and we're knocking them off. And as Gary Conner said the other day, we still have major problems out there. Yes, we do. And we're partnering with the USGS and the Muskingum Watershed on the big ones like December and the Fairhope Ditch and place culverts on the Fairhope Ditch. So we're making progress. We're tracking our progress. Like I say, in a perfect world, it'd be great if we could have a drainage district. But one thing I absolutely will not do, I will not borrow money to try to come up with $70 million because the county simply could not afford that in the general fund.
Thank you, sir.
With Sulbor, solve the drainage issue, we do not need to do a tax increase right now. We can take the money that the county is spending today, and at the rate that they're spending it, we will never get caught up in this county. We will be behind your grandkids, and your grandkids' grandkids will be experiencing the issues that we have today with drainage. There has never been a more affordable time for government, whether it's state or local or county, to borrow money. And that's not a nasty word. When interest rates are low and you have an investment that you need to make, it makes sense to borrow the money, especially if you're using a portion of your budget right now to band-aid approach, fix the problem. So we're going to take, as county commissioner, I'm going to take the amount of money we're spending per year, we're going to use that to pay down a bond. That should be, we should be able to bond about $15 million. We're going to take that $15 million, we're going to go to the Ohio Public Works Commission, we're going to go to the Muskingum Watershed, who has about an $18 million deficit in what they've invested back in this community, and we're going to look for dollar matches. Now, in the city of Canton, we've had amazing success getting grant money from the state. You see this with the Fulton Road project, where 80-90% of the project was covered through the state. 30 streets getting paved, most of that's covered through the state. We've had fantastic success when you go to the state and put forth a solid plan of how to fix a problem. If we can get a dollar-for-dollar match, we're now talking $20, $30 million invested in my first term as commissioner. That means 50% of the estimated drainage issues that we have can be solved, and we wouldn't spend any more money than what we're spending today.